comes up yet again, Mr. DeMarco. This time in several emails addressed to Rabbi Zelig.
So?
So what's the deal?
It wasn't me. It was another Joe.
Can it? Sing another tune, because I'm sick of the old one.
Oh, boy.
It's enough evidence to book you if I choose to go to the police. So are you gonna tell me what's going on?
Joe DeMarco gave me the once-over. His dull, pale eyes explored my face. He knitted his eyebrows as if doing some internal calculations, and then finally nodded.
Fine. You want to talk? Let's talk. But not here. Follow me.
Uh-oh. He's gonna shoot us in some alley somewhere. Can you help me or something? Tell my future.
Excuse me. Hello? Excuse me. I'm looking for...
Okay.
Be quiet.
Never. Yeah, we're gonna be in danger shortly.
Come on, Rabbi. We'll have more privacy down here.
Okay. This usually brings us to a map. Okay.
You've pissed off the wrong people, Rabbi.
What's that?
I had no problem with you. But now, I gotta kill you.
Do it! Called it!
I see. You're an assassin.
I had a feeling you were smart. Ooh. Your people are in this very, very deep.
Look at that psycho face.
My people? You mean the Jews?
A very cozy operation.
Oh my.
What sort of operation was this?
Don't think I'll be doing that. Professional courtesy. Say goodbye.
You think I'll go so easily?
Don't make me laugh, old man.
Time to run! You really think you'll get away with this?
Do you really think you'll get away with this?
I've been getting away with this since I was 12 years old.
That's young. How does a 12-year-old commit murder?
How does a 12-year-old commit murder?
Same as anyone. Someone asked me to, so I did.
Do you do everything people ask you to?
Do you do everything people ask you to?
If the price is right.
I'll double whatever you're being paid.
I'll double whatever you are being paid.
His knife jetted toward my face, and I swerved desperately to avoid it. I felt it prick my ear.
Sorry. I don't welch on a deal.
What happened to you, etc.?
What happened to you? Why are you so angry?
Stop asking me these stupid questions! I am what I am, alright?
Tell me about your childhood. Why are you so defensive?
Why are you being so defensive?
I am not being defensive!
Gotcha. Are you hiding from something?
Are you hiding from something?
What? No! What the hell are you talking about?
You hiding behind that knife.
Are you hiding behind that knife?
Well, no!
Care to prove it?
Care to prove it?
What?
Go on. You don't need the knife? Prove it. Or are you nothing but a nebbish?
Ooh.
You son of a bitch.
Uh-oh. Oh, he put it away.
I need a knife to take your sorry ass.
That's right. Take me down, old style.
Old man, you're funny. You think your God's going to help you out of this?
Perhaps. Perhaps not. But
I
my 4 years on the B'nai B'rith Yeshiva High School boxing team will even the odds.
That's how we say that.
What the hell, man?
Perhaps you didn't hear me the first time.
He's not even hitting us.
Now, do I have your attention?
I think
Let me
does.
Go, man!
You have two choices. You can answer my questions, or I throw you onto the tracks.
Oh, wow.
What? You're crazy!
What a badass.
Train's coming. Make your choice.
Choo-choo!
Fine. Fine!
Who sent you?
I... Answer! Zelig!
Zelig?
He's hooked in deep with the mafioso. Did you know that? He'd find struggling businessmen like your friends Jack and Ethan, and then hook them up with investors.
Investors?
Mafia investors.
He got them involved with the mob?
Yes. He got them in debt so deep they needed a tractor to pull them out.
Wow.
When they refused to pay, I was called in to take care of them.
So you killed Jack Lauder and Ethan Goldberg?
No surprise.
Yes. I see. Well, one question remains. What should I do with you?
Yeah.
Just let me go.
Well,
I could let you go now. I'll show mercy. I am a holy man, after all. Beat him up some more. The train clattered off into the flickering distance, and Joe DeMarco remained unconscious, but alive. Time to bring him downtown.
Perhaps you still have some purpose to fill. I've done all I can. I've shown mercy. The rest is up to God.
Minch, a real gentleman, spared DeMarco. Really interesting game. I'm enjoying it. A cold, sullen quiet radiated from the wooden panels of the door. Call it intuition. Call it boldness. Call it plain old curiosity. Somehow, I knew that door would be unlocked. She has something to do with it. There's a
Hello?
Note here on the mirror.
Mrs. Lauder? Rodtree?
She's left town. That's how you say that.
Oh, no.
She's dead? The interior of the apartment was a mess. Chairs were overturned, glasses were broken, and the telltale signs of a struggle were evident. This wasn't over yet. Not by a long shot. Is her body back there? Oh, I can look around finally. I'm gonna check out the note last. The surrounding area blocked the view of the landscape, although through a small gap I could see a small section of the Hudson River. There was no way to open the window. Some tasteful prints graced the wall. I wasn't going to steal from Mrs. Lauder. A floor lamp. I decided not to turn off the only light source in the room. Good idea. Some abstract art. Nice, if you like that sort of thing. I didn't need that. Closet. Door. Nothing else besides... I didn't look at it first. Locked. Coat closet.
A note?
Shalom, Rabbi Stone. Evidently my associate proved unable to complete his task, as he did not contact me at the usual time. I believe we have business to discuss. Do stop on by. An address on the Upper East Side followed.
Zelig.
My nemesis. I could have walked away. I was getting Jack's money. I had solved the mystery. My conscience was clear. Yet the angry cries of a dead man screamed in my soul.
Jack, I'm sorry, Jack.
As a man, I wished you all the happiness in the world. But as a rabbi, as a religious leader out of duty, I could not accept it. Can you understand?
Jack!
Jack! Forgive me, Jack. I'm sorry I cast you out. I'm sorry my actions sent you down this path. I... Get a hold of yourself, Stone. This isn't your doing.
Get a grip on yourself, man. All men have reasons for doing what they do. Some reasons are good, while some others are definitely evil. But most lie somewhere in between. For once, my reasons were crystal clear.
Zelig.
Prepare to meet your maker, Zelig. Upper East Side. So I am... I kind of feel like stopping here first. Let me see if there's any new mail. Yeah. I... I don't know, I'm just being thorough. I want to see if me or the other rabbi have any new mail or anything. Probably not. What's his? Rabbi Z, right? Nothing. Nothing new. Just being thorough. On to meet the nefarious Rabbi Zelig. Oh, wow.
Enter. Rabbi Stone, how good of you to come.
You didn't leave me much choice, Rabbi Zelig.
That's not entirely fair. You could have walked away.
I made a commitment.
And you're so good at those, aren't you?
Tell me what you want.
I only want this, Stone. You're going to walk over to the balcony. Take a nice long look at the view.
Right.
Enjoy it. It costs a bundle. Then, when you've thought carefully about what brought you here, you're going to jump over the edge.
Yeah, right. Direct response.
You can forget it.
Oh, really? Not even to save her life?
I don't know. Rabbinical response? Plus, you're saying to save her life, but you're aiming the gun at me.
And if I refuse?
I shoot her, then you, and throw you both off the balcony. I'd prefer to avoid complications. But it's the same to me either way.
You think you'll get away with this?
You have no idea what you're messing with, Stone. This goes way beyond you or me.
I don't claim to see what lies beyond. All I see is a man charged with leading his people, but instead leads them to their deaths.
It's not that simple, Stone. It never is. Pull your head out of the clouds and take a look around. This is how the world works. So, are you going to jump, or is this going to get messy?
Probably gonna jump and then it gets messy. Grab his gun. I braced myself for the impact. I felt a harsh puff of metal whiz past my torso and jam harmlessly into the floor. Well, now's our chance.
My. Looks like I missed. How careless of me.
A twist of a smirk revealed it was anything but.
You might want to rethink that move in the future.
Refuse?
No. I won't do it.
Very well.
Holy! You shot her!
What? You're surprised? I gave you ample warning. So, are you going to jump? Or am I going to shoot you too? I warn you. I won't make your death as quick as hers.
Well, either way, I'm dead. Denounce his crime?
You'll never get away with this.
Stone, you are in no position to argue with me. This gun? Untraceable. I'll say it's yours.
I have nothing to lose.
Troubled financial situation, and your synagogue in tatters? I doubt the police would question your actions too strongly.
Agree? If I agree, then am I doing it?
All right. You win, Zelig. You hold all the cards.
Good boy. He can be taught. Start walking. Now, open the door, Stone. Now, move.
Am I just gonna jump off, or does I stall him?
I...
Can it, Stone? You're on the edge. Now die with dignity and jump!
Climb over the edge. If I grab his gun again, I basically got a hint not to do that again. I'm not jumping, I'm just climbing over the... Climb back onto the... Admire the view.
Just admiring the view?
Yes, it is nice, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Now we climb back onto the balcony.
Having a change of heart? Well, make up your mind.
I...
Nothing you can possibly say will change things, Stone.
I'm not good at stalling. You gotta say more than I.
Well, what are you waiting for?
The gun was too far away from where I was sitting.
I...
Nothing you...
Just...
Yes. Having a change of heart? Well, make up your mind.
The bullet caught me in the left arm. The pain flared like a supernova.
Your bravado is irritating. Now, jump! Well, what are you waiting for? Having a change of heart? Well, make up your mind.
I gotta jump? I guess I gotta jump. Stalling him doesn't work. Grabbing the gun doesn't work.
Well, what are you waiting for?
Can I jump, like, to the next floor or something? They say a man's life passes before his eyes at times like these, but all I could see were the high rises of Manhattan crowding themselves around me like a concrete womb. The harsh, unyielding pavement comes ever closer, and I can't help but wonder, why did I jump? Why did I choose suicide over doing the honorable thing? I guess I'll never know. Huh? Can I... I haven't saved, have I? I never did save. Continue?
Enter.
You didn't leave me.
That's not. You could have.
I made it.
And you're.
Tell me what you.
I only. You're going to take an enjoy. Then you're going.
Incredulous response.
What? You must be joking.
Do I look like I'm joking, Stone?
Yeah.
You must be if you think I'd kill myself on your say so.
Oh really? Not even to save her life.
You bargain with a woman's life? You can go to hell.
Tut-tut, Stone. Your loyalty to this Shiksa is admirable.
Non-Jew.
But I have no love of either of you. I can just as easily shoot her, then you, and throw you both off the balcony. I'd prefer to avoid complications. But it's the same to me either way.
You think you'll get away with this?
You have this god.
I don't claim to see all I see, but instead...
It's not that it never... Pull your head. This is how... So... Are you going?
Agree? Maybe she
all
can
right.
Help me.
You win, Zelig. You hold all the cards.
Good boy. He can be taught. Start walking.
Maybe she can get herself untied?
Now,
I don't know.
Open the door, Stone. Wait. There is one more thing.
Oh? He moved the gun off of me and pointed it straight at Rashri Lauder. Forceful reaction?
Stop! Zelig!
Oh!
You!
Nice.
You son of a...
DeMarco,
good.
You
just
idiot.
Kill each other.
It's not enough you bungle your assignment. You show up here? Did anyone follow you?
I want my money!
You want what you deserve? Fine.
Oh. Now, while he's distracted, grab him.
Are you going to say he didn't deserve it?
I took a quick glance at Rashvi. I couldn't help but think that a close call had been made.
He certainly served his purpose.
Now, move. All this bloodshed sickens me.
Huh. You're the one doing it. Stall him?
Aye.
Kenneth Stone, you're on the edge. Now die with dignity and jump!
Grab his gun.
Your bravado is irritating. Now, jump! Well, what are you waiting for?
Just...
Yes. Having a change of heart? Well, make up your mind.
I...
My right shoulder exploded into a fiery furnace of pain. Black dots dotted in front of my vision as I struggled to keep focused.
Your capacity for pain is indeed impressive.
I am a cyborg.
Almost tempted to watch you bleed where you stand, but time is short. Now jump or die.
Jumping is dying.
I...
Nothing you... My, aren't you the brave one? I really hoped to avoid this.
I had solved the case, but at the cost of my life. Zelig was a detestable man, but he would go on living. As for me, I can't help but wonder, what if I could go back and do that again? A man like that shouldn't be allowed to walk the streets, let alone run a synagogue. I guess I'll never know. Well, there's gotta be an answer. The only thing, it's gotta lie in those answers. The rabbinical answer, the confrontational answer. Wish I could just go back to the main menu first instead of going through all that.
Enter. Rabbi,
you didn't.
That's not. You could.
I made.
And you're.
Tell me.
I own. You're going to take an enjoy. Then you're going.
Rabbinical response.
And why would I do this?
How about to save her life?
And if I refuse?
I shoot her.
I don't. All eyes. But
it's not that. Never pull your head. This is so. Okay, you might want...
Grab it again. I froze again. The bullet creased my earlobe and embedded itself in the
Oops.
Far wall.
Missed again. Perhaps I need a less mobile target.
Oh, then he kills her.
Holy, you shot her!
What? You're surprised? I gave you so, but I wore... My, I just had the carpet cleaned, too. You could.
I may. And you're tell me what.
I own. You're taking. Enjoy. Then you're go.
You can forget it.
Oh, really? Not even to save her life?
Negative response?
I still won't
do it.
Stone, stone, stone. Refusing will get you nowhere. Your loyalty to this Shiksa is admirable. But I have no love of I can just that I'd prefer...
You think you'll...
You have this goes...
I don't claim all eyes, but instead...
It's not... It never... Pull your head up. This is so.
Okay. If I grab the gun... Well, if I grab the gun, I just... Or if I try to grab the gun, I just get shot. If I refuse, he will shoot her and she'll be dead.
Alright. You win, Zelig. You hold all the cards.
Good boy. He can start to walk. Now, op. Wait, there's one.
Why do you want to do this, Rabbi Zelig?
Zelig! You! You son of a...
DeMarco, you idiot! It's not enough you bungled the assignment. You show up here?
I want my money!
You want what you... What? Are you going to say he didn't deserve it?
Wait, how many bullets are in that gun? He can shoot me... He's used one bullet. Yeah, I don't think... He shoots me three times, I think, then I'm dead. And he'll shoot him one time. And I'm thinking maybe I can make him run out of bullets, you know, if he uses six.
He certainly served his purpose.
Now, move! Hold this...
I...
Can it, Stone? You're on the edge. You're bravo now.
One more time?
Your capacity for pain is indeed impressive. I'm almost tempted to, but time is now just... Well? What are you waiting for?
Just...
Yes.
Oh! I can get him this time. I couldn't reach before. Weak from blood loss, I couldn't keep my hold on the gun. It slid out of my fingers like melting butter.
You momzer! You are nothing!
Oh yeah?
What's this? You think you can knock me out like some common steampunk?
Yeah, fisticuffs. He was old and certainly not as strong as me, but those two bullets had taken their toll. Bring on the fisticuffs.
I am Amos Zelig. I've spearheaded the strongest Jewish synagogue in Manhattan for over 30 years.
Well, good for you.
Oh, little rabbi.
Good for you.